Most people don't know that Black people have been a significant part of Hawaiian history. They practiced medicine, they founded schools, pastored churches, owned land, and advised Hawaiian royalty for more than 200 years. And they were prominent members of the business community in Honolulu. In 1795, Mr. Keakealeele, he was nicknamed Black Jack. He was living in Waikiki. He was a maritime trader and a skilled deckhand. He built a brick palace for King Kamehameha the Great, introducing Western architecture to the islands. In 1819, whaling ships began to arrive in Hawaii, and on those ships, as many as half were Black sailors. They were leaders, captains, pilots, skilled navigators. And by 1850, Black people represented 25% of foreign settlers. Native Hawaiians believed the color black represented power, and darker skin was a marker for dignity, strength, and courage. So they welcomed Black people to the islands. And meanwhile, on the continental United States, slavery was legal. But in Hawaii, there was aloha, a spirit of sharing by sacred breath where all people were respected. So the Black people stayed, and they were so numerous in Honolulu that they founded the African Relief Society to assist Black seamen who got ill or injured because there was no unions to protect them. In 1834, William the Baker owned a popular restaurant. In 1826, Joe Dollar Bedford owned a popular boarding house for 20 years. In 1846, William Johnson was the owner of the Shrine of Adonis Barbershop, where anyone of any race could receive a haircut. In 1810, Anthony Allen was a former slave. He became free, he sailed to Hawaii. He was a medical doctor, and then he founded a hospital to treat mariners, and he operated a boarding house, a bowling alley, a tavern, a farm, a ranch, and a school. In 1823, Betsy Stockton, she was also a former slave. She arrived in Hawaii with a group of Christian missionaries, and then she established a school for Hawaiian people. And she taught English, Latin, history, algebra, weaving, and sewing. In 1898, Thomas McCants Stewart came to Hawaii as a lawyer and a civil rights leader, and he helped draft the Organic Act of the Territory of Hawaii in protest to the overthrow of the Hawaiian monarchy by the United States. And he was instrumental in fighting for Hawaiians to regain their land back. His daughter, Carlotta Stewart, became Hawaii's first Black principal. In 1924, scientist Alice Bell developed a revolutionary treatment for leprosy, and she helped ease the suffering of Hawaiians at Kalaupapa, which is a leprosy colony on the island of Molokai. In 1834, Black men formed a royal brass band for the king. They were so popular in the middle of slavery. They traveled to California and they did a tour. And 11 years later, they became the Royal Hawaiian Band.